Welcome back. Today I'm actually going to be taking you through the PPC Manager. Now, because we know what an important role PPC campaigns play in the overall success of your Amazon business, we have created a really robust PPC Manager that will help you manage and automate your campaigns. So I want to show you exactly what features you can take advantage of. So let's go into the tool. Now, if you're starting off in the cockpit, you can either choose to access the PPC Manager by clicking at the very top or clicking through the widget as well. Now, when you are there, you are going to be brought into an overview section. And this is actually where we consolidate the information for sponsored brands and sponsored products. So if you're running both types of advertising, you will see joint KPIs, and you will also see a trend chart as well, along with the comparison chart at the bottom. Now, in this video, I will be focusing on sponsored products, but in the event that you are running sponsored brands, you do have the ability to view the KPIs and the analytical information for that here, as it does get automatically pulled over from Seller Central. But let's go into the optimize for sponsored products. And once you are there, you will, of course, also have the KPIs for the sponsored products that you are running. And you have the ability to choose the time frame that you want to focus on. So let's say you want to focus on the last 30 days or 60 days, or even a custom range. You do have the ability to select that here. But let's go ahead and choose the last 30 days. Now, once that gets updated, you'll have your sales, your spend, your profit, ACoS, cost per clicks, click-through rates, clicks, and conversion rates. You're also going to have a trend chart where you can make side-by-side comparisons of the different KPIs. So if you wanted to take a look at, let's say, your sales versus your spend or any of the other KPIs, you can choose that here to see if there's a correlation here between the two of them or anything that stands out. Now, if you scroll down, you will have all of your campaigns that you are running for the selected time period listed out. Now, once again, like the rest of the tool, we will automatically pull over your information from Seller Central. So there's no need for you to export data from there and import it into Sellics. We will take care of that for you and organize it, so you don't have to deal with any tedious reports or trying to decipher what the information actually means. We will clearly list it out for you here. So now for your campaigns, we distinguish the manual campaigns with this little green icon and then the automatic campaigns with this little wand feature. Now, you'll also see the individual KPIs for your campaigns that you are running. So everything from spent all the way to orders. And the same format goes along the other sections of your campaigns, such as ad groups, targets, search terms, and products. Now, within Sellics, you do have the ability to make changes directly to your campaigns, and the changes will reflect live in Seller Central. Now, you can go ahead and make changes either manually or you can set up the automation. In the next video, I will show you how you can set up the automation, but I did want to point out how you can make changes manually if that is the route that you want to continue to take. So if you wanted to make the changes manually, you can make them on an individual basis or on a bulk basis. If you wanted to make them individually, it's quite simple to do. For instance, if you wanted to go ahead and pause the campaign, you can double click on the green circle and you'll have the ability to pause or archive it. At the very end, you'll also have the ability to adjust the budget and you'll have the ability to create campaigns directly from within here. Now, something that I want to stress here is if you want to continue making changes manually, we do highly recommend that you do it within Sellics, because that way you don't have to jump back and forth between two different platforms, but also every single change that you make will automatically be recorded into our change log. And you're going to be able to see the change log on the bottom left. So everything gets listed out. So if you did decide to pause a campaign or archive it, that will be listed out. Or if you add a keyword or make an adjustment to a bid, that will be listed out as well. So everything gets recorded and it will be date and time stamped. It also ties in really nicely to the analytical component of the PPC manager. And of course, we do want you to be able to take full advantage of this feature as well, which is why we like to stress the importance of making changes within Sellics. So let's say, for instance, I wanted to apply one of the filters that we do offer here. So you can, for instance, filter by metric, but let's say I wanted to apply the smart filter. I just want to see perhaps the campaigns that have no conversions. I can set that up. So in this case, the no conversions would be clicks higher than 50, but no orders. And if I wanted to make a change to the campaign, I can simply select at the very top and it will highlight all of the campaigns that meet this criteria. And then you will have the action section at the very top, which will allow me to make those bulk changes. So you can bulk change the status, you can change the bidding strategy, either apply a dynamic bid or a fixed bid, you can change the daily budget, and you can even enable ad scheduling. Now, this is where you can give Sellics the indication to automatically enable or pause your campaigns during certain days of the week or certain times during the day. So if you want to make the most out of your ad budget and you know that they perform best during certain days of the week or certain times, you can go ahead and take advantage of this feature. So that's how you can make the bulk changes. Now, the same process will go along for all of the other tabs, for example, ad groups. So you'll have the ability to, let's say, change the default bid on an individual basis or also on a bulk basis by selecting the top column. But something that I wanted to point out here is where you can go ahead and actually enter your current target ACoS for your individual ad groups. We recommend that you go ahead and enter the information here because it will play an important role in the automation that you will set up in the next videos. So if you're running a lot of ad groups, we do have a bulk upload feature for you as well that you can take advantage of. So that is the first section in the PPC manager. In the next videos, we will go through the automation as well as the analyze tab so that you can take full advantage of everything that is available here. I'll talk to you in the next one.